Greetings, this is Mel Daven, and today I will be hosting a Q&A session with Eluvian. It's probably pronounced Eluvian, but I prefer Eluvian because it sounds more Elvish. You can go. So I bought this ring-shaped lighting source from AliExpress, and I'm not sure it is trustworthy, to be honest. And I do not know why I did this mistake of purchasing such a cheap product in the electronics category, because it might prove to be dangerous, to be honest. And yeah, if it explodes, this video will not be published because I will be already dead. I hope everything will work out. So let's begin the Q&A session. Yuki Aritil commented that she wants to know what I use to edit my YouTube videos. Since I have started using this new Apple laptop I have been utilizing iMovie, and the Netherlands expedition video was the first output of iMovie that I have ever published. And I also used Photoshop to add some effects, and I have no idea how to use Photoshop properly, to be honest, and especially not on videos, but I tried and I will try again, most probably on this video. I will try to add the questions that you have commented on my Instagram profile, and I will try to add them right here. Yeah, right here. So that you will be able to follow up more easily. And the second question is again from Yuki Aritil. Who is your favorite elf besides Maedros? So it must be very apparent that I love elves in general, in many universes, in literature and movies and video games. And I guess my favorite elf besides Maedros... First of all, I must mention that I love my own original character elves because they are so flawed and so weird. I cannot describe them in one sentence, but they have lots of flaws. They are certainly not perfect. They are in the gray area in ethics and morality most of them. Some of them can be considered good, and there are some evil ones, and I really like them, not because they are my own creations. I usually do not like my own creations, but for some reason I like them. But since most of you do not know anything about them, and since they are not real in the sense of they have not been written by the original authors of the games, books, movies, I will divide this question into several universes and answer accordingly. So for Tolkien elves, I like the Fëanorians. I generally like the House of Finde, I guess. I also like Elrond. He is my favorite Lord of the Rings character. I like Arwen. Yeah, I guess. I have so many characters that I cherish and love, so this is not a very definite answer, but from Elder Scrolls, I guess that is Manimarco, and I have no idea why. He is certainly the opposite of my own characterization, my own personality. He seeks leadership, and he is certainly very evil and has very dark motives, and I aspire not to be a person like him, but I find him fascinating in a way, and he is very interesting, I think. And I like high elves in general, so maybe that's a contributing factor. Yes. And for Dragon Age, I guess that's Fenris, because I like Fenris. I have some common points with him, I think. And I also enjoy his personality. I enjoy his change throughout Dragon Age 2. And I hope to see him in the next game. I would be very glad. So, what else? Let's think of elves. Let's look at my bookshelf. And this bookshelf doesn't even include many of my books. And some of my books, most of them, have already been gifted to my cousin or have been donated to charity. And I sadly cannot read books at the moment. Actually, for a very long time because of my increasing concentration issues. I cannot focus on reading for a long time. And also, while reading, I tend to find words I do not understand and I start making researches on them by one by one, and this takes so much of my time and it is frustrating. So, no books for me at the moment, and it has been a frustration for a very long time now, but I do not know how to solve it. Yeah, what other elves? I don't know. Because I'm not familiar with many literature works or many games, since I am a bit of an obsessive person. Not a bit of an obsessive person, I have OCD. I do not have many interests in fictional works, sadly. I want to explore further my English is, and my accent is absolutely perfect, but yeah. Sarcasm overload. Overlord, not overlord, overload, but I can be a sarcasm overlord as well. That would be an honor. Next question is again from Yuki Arifil. If you found a Silmarillion, would you keep it? Yes or no? I guess I wouldn't keep it. If I found a Silmarillion, I would most probably give it to the Fëanorians, and this means I would not keep it. No, I do not want doom upon myself. I do not want war upon myself or war or any bad consequences because of those shiny, beautiful, desirable objects. And yes, I would not keep them, even though they are pretty, even though they hold so much power. No, certainly I would give it to the rightful owners. And continuing with questions, Yuki Arifil has asked, how did you go about dressing elf-like in daily life? Well, I didn't feel brave enough to dress like this until I went to England and experienced a bit there with makeup and clothing. I sadly had to return due to health reasons, but yes, England was a huge step for me. And the second source of encouragement came from my dear friend Elveriner. And since I met her, I felt so inspired and I started to act even braver in terms of clothing. And I also have many more inspiring people that I follow on social media. And yes, I feel so grateful that I have found them. Because, yes, they have given me courage to do that. However, it might not be the best choice I have made in certain aspects. Like, it is all right if I dress like this in university, but sadly not in certain parts of the city, like the city center which is known as Kızılay. And yes, people keep staring, and even in shopping malls. Or yes, even in universities might occur. But the university is my most comfortable environment. It's the most comfortable environment for me to dress up like I want to. But this doesn't mean, this sentence doesn't indicate, fully indicate that I can dress up as I want, because I do not have the resources, firstly. I would love to have more clothes that reflect my personality, more warrior-like, more armor-like, or more fiery-like, more elven-like, I do not know, or more witchy. But sadly, I cannot find such items in here, and I have to order online, but my financial status doesn't allow that at the moment. I'm a full-time student, and I do not work, and hence I cannot pay for my expenses that I can use to express myself further. And yes. And hence I'm trying to sell my clothes that I no longer use, or that I haven't even used most of them. And I am also trying to improve my coffee page, and I may try offering commissions for like $10, but sadly I'm not good at drawing, and I do not think I deserve that amount of money. But I want to try, because I need money not only for the clothes I want, but mostly for the school expenses and to compensate for the losses I had, like the mysterious disappearance of three of my pencil cases that held art material, the new laptop, the new phone because of an internal error that was out of my control. And yes. So, to sum up, this courage doesn't give me the full opportunity to dress up as I want, because I do not have the resources, and I also do not have the skills to enhance my makeup game, make my hair, or sew something, and yeah, craft any accessories. So, sadly, this is the situation, but I'm trying to reveal my inner self through my clothing and dressing up, because it makes me more happy, even though I am never happy or content. So, first of all, I would like to thank Yuki Arifil so, so much for all those questions. And yes, now, most probably the video will end here when we combine these two videos that meant nothing at all in general, but I will try to answer more, of course. But in case this is the end of the video, I would like to say some things. No, why can I not talk? Alright. In case this is the end of the video, I would like to thank all the people who have commented on my post and asked questions and make this Q&A video a reality. And thank you so, so much for everything. All your support on all my social media accounts.